Hello students, good morning. Today I am going to explain third chapter of class 7 science, that is fiber to fabric. Students, this chapter is lengthy, that's why I will explain this chapter in two parts. So this is the first part of chapter 3, fiber to fabric. So students, first of all we will see the contents of the chapter. So in this chapter we are going to study about fibers and its types, natural and synthetic fibers, plant and animal fibers, and then we will study about animal fibers, in which we will study about wool and silk and their processing. At last we will study about occupational hazards related to wool and silk industry. So student, as in this chapter also, first topic is fiber. So just I want to remind you that in 6th class also, we have studied this chapter fiber to fabric, and in that class, we have studied about plant fibers in detail. So first of all, we will do a short revision that the topic we have studied in 6th class. Students, in 6th class, we have studied about the history of clothing. As all of us know that clothes are one of our very important basic needs. So as all of us know that in ancient time, people used the bark and big leaves of trees or animal skin or fur to cover themselves. After the people started to settle in agricultural communities, they learned to weave twigs and grasses. Animal fleece or hair or vines were twisted together to form long strands, and these strands were woven into fabrics. In those days, stitching was not known, so people simply draped the fabrics around their body parts. After the invention of sewing needles, people started stitching fabrics into clothes. Means at that time, they knew how to stitch the fabric to make clothes. So basic thing from which our clothes or fabric are made up of is fiber. Means fiber are the basic thing. Fibers are the thin hair like structure from which we make yarn, and from yarn we can make our fabric or clothes. So in our previous class we have studied about fibers and type of fibers also. Now in this class we will see what is fiber. Fibers are thin, thread-like strands from which are the building blocks of yarn, and from yarn are fabric or clothes are made up of. So we can say that fibers are building blocks of our clothes or fabrics also. As for example, some examples of fiber are wool, silk, cotton, jute, hemp, flax, nylon, polyester, acrylic, so many fibers are there. Now we will study about the types of fiber. So fibers are basically, they are of two types, natural fibers and synthetic fibers. Synthetic fibers are also called as artificial or man-made fiber. There is a reason why they are called man-made fiber. Then first of all we will see natural fibers. So the fibers that we obtain from nature, means from natural things as plants and animals, so that fibers are called natural fibers. Now natural fibers are also, they are of two types, plant fibers and animal fibers. So plant fibers are the fibers that we get from plants. So these fibers that we get from plants, that fibers are called plant fibers. Plant fibers are made up of cellulose. I think now you all are familiar to cellulose because you have studied about cellulose in your previous chapter, that is nutrition in animals. All of you know that cellulose is a type of complex carbohydrate, that cellulose cannot be digested by human beings, but it can be digested by ruminants. So cellulose is the building material of plant fibers. Some examples of plant fibers are cotton, jute, flax, hemp, coir, etc. So students, in 6th class we have studied about cotton and jute. I think all of you knowing that cotton is obtained from cotton plant, and the process by which we take out, we separate cotton fiber from seed is called ginning. Then jute fiber, we have studied the process of retting, from which we separate jute fiber from the stem of jute plant. Now, next one is animal fiber. Animal fiber is very important in this class, because in this class we have to focus on animal fiber. So animal fibers are the fiber that we get from animals. That fibers are made up of proteins, and examples of animal fiber are wool and silk. So students, mainly the wool giving animal is sheep. Except sheep, so many other animals are also there, as yak or llama and alpaca. These two animals, llama and alpaca, they belong to camel family. Then angora goat, angora rabbit, Kashmiri goat, etc. So these are the wool producing animals. After that, silk fiber is produced by silkworm. Now next topic is synthetic fiber. Synthetic fiber, or we can say artificial fiber or man-made fiber. So actually synthetic fibers are made up of chemical substances, and they are made by human beings. That is why they are called man-made fiber, and synthetic fibers are also called as artificial fiber. So the fiber which are used, which are formed by chemical substances by human beings, such type of fibers are called synthetic fibers. So example of synthetic fiber are polyester, acrylic, rayon, nylon, etc. One more thing, students. Suppose you have been provided animal fiber, plant fiber, and synthetic fiber, and you have to differentiate. So sometimes it is very difficult to differentiate between plant fibers and animal fibers. So in that case, we do burning test to differentiate among natural plant fiber, animal fiber, and synthetic fiber. So when we burn plant fiber, which is made up of cellulose, it burns quickly, and it produces a smoke. That smoke is white or light colored, and it smells like burnt paper or burnt leaf. While animal fiber are made up of protein, which burns very slowly. Plant fibers, they burn very quickly. Animal fibers, they burn very slowly and shrinks away from the flame, and very little smoke is produced. And when they burn, they smell like burnt hair. Then synthetic fiber burns quickly and continues to burn after the flame is removed. Means after the flame is finished, then also synthetic fiber keep on burning. And synthetic fiber may shrink from the flame, or they can melt, or they can drip, leaving a hard plastic-like material. So, in this class, we have to study about animal fibers in detail. And in this, first we will study about wool. So, students, wool and silk, as we know, these two are the important animal fibers that we obtain from animals. And these natural fibers are used to make a variety of fabrics. So wool is a very important fiber, very important animal fiber. In natural fiber, it is very important animal fiber. Wool is a hair of animal, like it may be of sheep or goat or rabbit or camel, etc. And it is widely used for so many things, as sweaters, socks, gloves, scarves, shawls, etc. are made from these fibers. Then stuffing of furnitures can be done from wool. Wool also has a long history of being used in carpets and carpet padding. So wool is a common name applied to the soft curly fiber. Means what is wool? So we can say that wool is a soft curly fiber obtained chiefly from the fleece of domesticated sheep. And other animals like llama, alpaca, angora goat, angora rabbit, etc. Now, some of the characteristics of wool are: wool is a soft, light in weight, durable, elastic, and wrinkle-free fiber. Wool fibers are made up of protein, and when it is burnt, it emits strong smell of burning hair. It traps air, and all of you know that air is poor insulator. Air is insulator of heat, so it protects us from cold in winters. Then wool is reusable and biodegradable. Then thick coat of hair which grows on the bodies of animals, that thick coat on which hair is grown, that thick coat is called fleece. Then wool is fire resistant. Wool can be dyed easily. The type of wool determined by the quality of sheep's fleece, and quality of wool depends on age and physical conditions of sheep. Its fleece is covered with an oily substance. That substance is called yolk, and that yolk protects the wool fibers during rainy season. Then young sheep produce the best quality of wool, while lower quality of wool is produced by dead or diseased sheep. Now, next topic is breeding of sheep. So before breeding of sheep, we should know about the two type of fibers, or two type of fleece of sheep, which have two type of fibers, that is coarse beard hair and fine soft under hair. The two type of hair are produced by fleece of sheep. The fine hair provide the fibers for making wool. Some breeds of sheep possess fine hair, fine under hair. So their parents are especially chosen so as to give birth to sheep. Means first, fine hair producing parents are chosen to produce a new young one which has the fine soft under hair. So this process of selecting parents for obtaining good character or special characters in their offspring or new one, such as soft under hair in sheep, this process is called selective breeding. Selective breeding means when we select the parents, select the sheep as a parent to produce good quality of sheep, to produce soft and fine quality of wool, this process is called selective breeding. Now, next topic is breeding of sheep. So breeding means improving the quality of a particular animal by crossing different varieties of that animal. Means two different varieties, same animal but two different varieties of animal are crossed together to produce new young one. This process is called breeding of sheep. So the main purpose of sheep breeding is to improve the quality of sheep to get the desired quality and quantity of fleece. All the domestic breeds of sheep are the offsprings of two different kinds of wild sheep. By breeding, the coarse hair that covered the wild sheep is replaced by soft hair. Means that coarse hair, which is not good in quality, it is replaced by soft hair. Depending on their fleece, there are mainly five groups of sheep. They are fine wool, means the sheep which is having very fine quality of wool, long wool sheep, cross breed sheep, means the sheep which is produced by crossing of two breeds of sheep, then medium wool and wool sheep, and coarse wool sheep. Now, some breeds of sheep and quality of wool produced by them, you can see in the figure given in the slide. And states are also mentioned where they are produced. So some of the breeds are there as Lohi or Rampur Bushehr or Nali or Bakharwal, then Merino, Mohair, Marwadi and Patanwadi. So all of these breeds are good, but the very good type of breed of sheep is merino. Merino produce the very finest and softest quality of wool. So students, other wool-yielding animals except sheep are Angora goat, Angora rabbit, llama, alpaca, yak, Kashmiri goat, and one more is there, that is vicuna. So vicuna are an endangered species, so their fibers are rare and very expensive. After that, Angora wool, which we obtained from Angora goat or rabbit, these fibers are also very good quality fibers. The animals, Angora goat or Angora rabbit, they are found in the hilly regions of India such as Jammu and Kashmir. And the wool produced by Angora goat is called mohair. So mohair is a fiber, wool fiber that we obtain from Angora goat. And the wool fiber that we obtain from Angora rabbit is called Angora wool. So these animals produce very good quality of wool fiber, which is very warm, durable and lightweighted. And they are used to make ladies' stuff as sweaters, cardigans, shawls, etc. Next one is alpaca and llama. They both belong to camel family. And they are found in South America. And the wool produced by these animals are very soft, fine and warm. Then next one is yak. So yak's wool is very popular in Tibet and Ladakh. The wool fibers are very coarser and warmer, and the wool color is black or brown. Then next one is Kashmiri goat. So Kashmiri goat produce Kashmiri wool, which is very good quality of wool. It is extremely soft and the wool fiber is very, very expensive. So next we will study about processing fibers into wool. The processing wool involves the following steps, that is rearing, shearing, scouring or washing, sorting and grading, then carding, and last process is making fabric. So first we will start with rearing. Sheep are reared in many parts of India, mainly as Rajasthan, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh, Haryana, Jammu Kashmir, Gujarat, etc. They are herbivorous animals. The shepherds take the herd of sheep means group of sheep, to the countryside for grazing, means they are grazing animals. During summer and rainy season, sheep feed on grasses and leaves. But in winter, they need very good food. So their food involves the leaves, corn, oil cakes, and mainly pulses, because pulses are protein rich, and when they will feed on good quality of food which is rich in protein, then they will produce good quality of wool also, because all of you are knowing animal wool is made up of proteins. Next one is shearing. The shearing is simply the process of removing fleece from animal's body. This process is called shearing. The person that removes fleece is called shearer. And when shearer removes fleece from the animal's body, sheep's body, it removes the fleece in one pieces, so that every piece can be identified for sorting and grading. Because sheep has best quality wool at their shoulders and sides. So all fleece is not removed at one time. Shearers remove the fleece at one pieces. Generally, the shearing process done in once in a year, but sometime it may be two also. Next process is scouring or washing. So process of removing dirt, dust, grease, etc. from the wool fiber, that process is called scouring or washing. Actually, the wool contains yolk and other impurities. That other impurities are dust and dirt. To remove these impurities, the wool is scoured. Scoured means washed with a series of tanks which contains detergent. The yolk contains grease. The wool grease of yolk is processed, means the wool grease which is obtained from yolk, that is processed to form a substance that is lanolin. And lanolin is used in skin ointments, means it is used in making cosmetics. So So that process in which we clean the raw wool, or we clean that wool for removing other impurities. So this process is called scouring and washing. Next process is sorting and grading. So after the process of scouring, first of all, that wool fibers are dried, then sorting and grading is done. So what is sorting and grading? Actually, putting the wool in different groups means where the wools are sorted out according to their length or quality. So when the wool in different groups, they are sorted, this is called sorting or grading, sorting and grading. The quality of wool depends on its fineness, strength, crimp and color. The property of wool, that is crimp, provides the elasticity to the fiber. This property enables the fiber to hold their shape after being stretched or twisted. Then next process is carding. After the wool is dried, it is carded. What is carding? During the carding process, the wool passes through rollers that have thin wire teeth. The teeth arrange the fiber into a flat sheet called a web. Means that process is resembles to combing. So the web is then formed into a strand. That strand is known as silver. Now, from that silver is stretched into thinner strands, which is then twisted into yarn. Means then fibers are stretched into thinner strands, and the thinner strands are twisted to form yarn. So the process of making yarn by twisting the fibers, that process is called spinning. Now, two main type of yarns are produced, that is woolen yarn and worsted yarn. Now, what is woolen yarn? Woolen yarn are spun from short fibers, means the process that we have studied, shorting and grading, in which we separate the short fibers and long fibers. So when the fibers are or yarns are spun from short wool fibers about 1 to 3 inches long, that yarn is called woolen yarn. Means woolen yarn are spun from short wool fibers about 1 to 3 inches long, while worsted yarn are spun from long fibers, and that fibers are more than 3 inches. Then again, woolen yarn are bulky, uneven, with soft and fuzzy appearance, while worsted yarn are fine, smooth, with crisp appearance. Now, next and last process is making fabrics. Now the yarn is knitted or weaved. All of you knowing, you have studied in 6th class about knitting and weaving. Knitting is the process in which one yarn is used to make a fabric, and weaving is the process in which two yarns are used. So yarn is knitted or weaved into variety of fabrics by wool manufacturers, and after that finishing process will be there to give desired appearance and feel to the fabric. And after that, after the final finishing process, the fabric is made into clothing. Now, one more thing. Australia is the largest producer of wool. It contributes about 29% of total world supply. And other producers of wools are China, New Zealand, Argentina, Turkey, Iran, and UK. After that, India, Sudan, South Africa, and the United States. One more important thing is that is sorter's disease. Sorter's disease that comes from the sorting department. Sorting department in which we sort the fibers according to their length, fineness, quality, etc. So what happened? In wool fibers, one bacterium is present sometime. That bacterium is called anthrax. And when the people who are working in sorting department, they get in close contact with the anthrax bacteria, they get infected by this bacteria, which causes a very fatal means very dangerous blood disease. That disease is called Sorter's disease. So people working in sorting department of wool, they get infected by a bacterium which causes a fatal blood disease. That disease is called sorter's disease. Now, some uses of wool. All of you knowing, wool is mainly used for making sweaters, gloves, socks, mufflers and other clothing which keep us warm during winter. Then it is also used for making carpets and felt. Actually, felt is used to absorb odor and noise in heavy machinery. Then wool is also used to cover cloth diapers. Then some wool such as shoddy can be recycled and used for making cheap woolen clothes. So students, this is all about wool. In next part, we will study about silk. So please watch the video and note the important things and prepare this part. Thank you.